Hi, welcome to OT. Today what you'll need are about 10 different types of colored paper, scissors, glue, either a stick or a glue bottle, and a marker. We're going to practice cutting squares and using squares. So you'll want to use your marker and make strips of paper. So I'm choosing to do them all at once. You can cut them one by one if you like. Once you have your strips of paper, draw lines on them. Draw lines on each strip of paper, and then have your child cut the squares out by cutting all the lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you'll want to do that with each strip of paper that you have. After you have your pieces of paper cut out, it should look like confetti, but squares. You want to use dark paper to create a higher contrast. And you're going to write your child's first and last name. First name on one paper, last name on the other. Use a capital. And lowercase for the rest. And it doesn't have to be precise. We're just spacing it out so that when we glue these on, it will fit on the page. So if the pencil is too light, you can go over it with a marker so that your child can see where they need to paste. Now for the next step, going to ask your child to get the glue and have the squares ready for them. You can talk about the squares and explain the sides of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 sides, and have them feel the corners. There's 1 corner, 2 corner, 3 corner, 4. 4 corners. And you can also get objects that are squares and have them feel the sides and the corners so that they understand the concept of a square, how it's drawn, how it's cut out, and how it's used. Okay, next you're going to glue. So have your child open the cap and put the cap down and start with one strip. Start with the top. Your big line down and ask them to put the squares on. When they put the squares on, it does not need to be lined up. It can be, the squares can face any which way. Put them on and press tap, 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 or rub, rub, rub. You're going to find that this activity is a very quiet activity. It's very calming. And with just the right amount of guidance, it can be very, very fun. So once they get one line of the letter, then you're going to have them glue the next line and put squares on top. The whole time you can talk about squares, or you can practice the sequence of remembering what to do. First, glue, then paste. And hold the paper down with one hand. Use your other hand to tap. And it's always good if there's a little problem that comes up. For example, I ran out of space here. So you have to add more glue. Uh-oh, what do? You add more glue. And you can work on your colors. You can work on counting. Tap, tap, tap. Rub, rub, rub. And so we're starting out with first letter. Once you have your child glue on the last square, you can have them help you hang it up somewhere in your house. And I recommend that every day you move their name to another room. That will help them be more flexible and will help them look and search for their name, and it can make it very fun. Please remember that this activity can be broken up into several days so that you're not doing it all at once. So the first day you can have your child, you can have them pick out the colors, and then you can show them the strips that you make for them. The next day you can have them cut the strips into squares, and then the next day you can have them trace their name on the paper. And the next day have them glue the squares on the paper for one for their first name, and then the next day for their last name. So you can spread it out, and that way they can continue working on squares and they won't become overwhelmed with just doing it straight through. If they can do it straight through, that would be great, but it's not necessary. So I hope this helps them continue to work on squares, cutting, drawing, pasting, and being more flexible, and as well as having fun. Thank you, and have a great week.